So the geneticists are now saying, and many others are now saying, that man must take the course of his evolution into his own hands. He can no longer trust the wiggly, random, and unintelligible processes of nature to develop him any further, but he must interfere with his own intelligence and through genetic alterations breed the kind of people who will be viable for human society and that sort of thing. Now this, I submit, is a ghastly error, because human intelligence has a very serious limitation. That limitation is that it is a scanning system of conscious attention which is linear. That is to say, it examines the world in lines, rather as you would pass the beam of a flashlight across a room, or a spotlight. That's why our education takes so long. It takes so long because we have to scan miles of lines of print. And we regard that, you see, as basic information. Now, the universe does not come at us in lines. It comes at us in a multidimensional continuum in which everything is happening all together everywhere at once. And it comes at us much too quickly to be translated into lines of print or of other information, however fast they may be scanned. Is our limitation so far as the intellectual life and the scientific life is concerned. The computer will greatly speed up linear scanning, but it's still linear scanning. And so long as we are stuck with that form of wisdom, we cannot deal with more than a few. The average person cannot deal with more than three variables at once without using a pencil. Now, when we study physics, we are dealing with processes in which there are millions of variables. This, however, we handle by statistics, in the same way as insurance companies use actuarial tables to predict when most people will die. If the average age of death is 65, however, this prediction does not apply to any given individual. Any given individual will live to plus or minus 65 years. And the range of difference may be very wide indeed, of course. But this is all right. The 65 guess is all right when you're doing large-scale gambling. That's the way the physicist works in predicting the behavior of nuclear weapons. But the practical problems of human life deal with variables in the hundreds of thousands. Here, statistical methods are very poor, and thinking it out by linear consideration is impossible. With that equipment, then, we are proposing to interfere with our genes. And With that equipment also, be it said, we are trying to solve our political, economic, and social problems. And naturally, everybody has the sense of total frustration. And the individual feels, what on earth can I do? We do not seem to know a way of calling upon our brains, because our brains can handle an enormous number of variables that are not accessible to the process of conscious attention. Your brain is now handling, or your total nervous system to be more accurate, your blood chemistry, the secretions from your glands, the behavior of millions of cells. It is doing all that without thinking about it. That is to say, without translating the processes it is handling into consciously reviewed words, symbols, and numbers. Now, when I use the word thinking, I mean precisely that process, translating what is going on in nature into words, symbols, or numbers. Both words and numbers are kinds of symbols. Symbols bear the same relation to the real world that money bears to wealth. You cannot quench anybody's thirst with the word water, just as you cannot eat a dollar bill and derive nutrition. But using symbols and using conscious intelligence, scanning, has proved very useful to us. It has given us such technology as we have. But at the same time, it has proved too much of a good thing.
know it. Sure. electronic songs, it's about like everything's so like sexy and smooth.